recognizing dignity. In the above cases what we discussed just now, the Om Prakash case or Mr. and Mrs. Ansari were asked to change the names as Mr. and Mrs. Kumar. Om Prakash case, where the teacher has shown the discrimination by ill-treating Om Prakash, a class 4 boy, and asking him to sweep the entire school ground because it was a comedy show for the students who are there along with him, were studying inside the classroom, where he has shown the discrimination. Well, in coming to the next case of Mr. and Mrs. Ansari, were rejected to be given a rent flat, to be given a flat for rent where them to stay. They were asked to change the names, and which they were against the dignity of the individuals. In both the cases, the dignity is violated. They were ill-treated, and they all reserve the respect and dignity same as the others in the society have. For this, we have a nice incident in 1975 released a movie named as Deewar, where a small boy works as a shoe shiner who makes the shoes to shine on a footpath, where the person comes walking and makes the shoe to shine and throws the coin down. The boy insists that there is dignity in my work and I am doing my work perfectly, so I want you to pay my money back with respect. So immediately the guy takes the money and hands it over to him with respect. So in every work you do, you have a dignity for that work. So dignity of the work has to be maintained, and the dignity of the individuals has to be respected. No one can be ill-treated. Let us check what are the provisions that are there in the Indian Constitution to guarantee equality and to curb this indiscrimination or the discrimination on the basis of the caste, color, creed, region or religion. The equality in Indian democracy. Indian Constitution recognizes every individual as equal, irrespective of their caste, color, regional backgrounds or religion backgrounds. Recognizes everybody as equal as per the Indian Constitution. This doesn't mean that there is no inequality in our country. There is inequality in our country. In order to ensure that every citizen is meted with the equal treatment and respect, the Constitution framed certain laws. There are four important laws like that. First, Indian Constitution declares every individual is equal before law. It is the President of India or a normal individual like Kanta, both will be treated with the same law if they have done anything wrong. So the same law will be used to prosecute the President or Kanta. So this ensures equality before law. The second one, no discrimination is entitled or entertained on the basis of a caste, a religion, a region or any other social barriers. So no one can discriminate anyone. And access to public places. Earlier, due to the caste rigidity and caste discriminations, the lower caste people are not allowed to access public places. So now the Constitution declares the access to public places free to all, like public parks, playgrounds, hotels, temples, holy places, etc. And untouchability has been abolished completely. So these are the laws which are framed in the Indian Constitution to respect every individual as equal as the others. Equal respect has to be meted to all. There should not be any discrimination. There should not be any denial to any public places. There should be complete ban on untouchability. Now, what are the other steps taken by the government? These are the laws which are made by the government to eradicate inequality. But at the same time, what are the steps taken by the government to push the concept of equality into the inequal society of our country? Let us now learn about the programs initiated by the government of our country and how did this start to break the barriers of caste system. Midday meal scheme, which has been introduced by the Union government of our country in the year 2001. Tamil Nadu was the first state to implement this scheme. This scheme was given by the Union government to implement in all the government elementary schools. What does this scheme mean about? This scheme is to provide cooked food, lunch, for all the students of elementary school from primary classes. So here, there are two important aspects. In the government schools, generally, most of the below poverty line categorized people send their children to the government schools as they will not be able to afford the fees of the private schools. And the other important aspect is most of the parents of these children will be working and it is very difficult for them to take a break in the middle of the work and come and feed them. And the other report is that most of the children go home for lunch and they never return back after lunch. So the attendance to the school has increased because of the implementation of the midday meal scheme program. Because the children are getting food, so no parent denies the child to go to school as it is also benefiting him to be healthy. And the food provided is also healthy food, and here the cook is generally taken from the Dalit caste, so that the discrimination between the Dalits and the non-Dalit students also gets slowly reduced as all of them have common dining and common food together. And slowly they start to recognize each other that no one is inferior and everybody is equal. The attendance of the students has gone up positively because the food is assured and most of the students are now not going home. So they don't go home, they stay in the school. They are very attentive in the classes because they get sufficient amount of food for them as lunch. So these are the positive effects which are made by the government through the midday meal scheme program, which is started in 2001, where the first state, only Tamil Nadu, started in 2001. The Supreme Court gave a directive stating that within 6 months of time, every school in our country has to start this scheme implementation to ensure these positive results come across the entire country. Now, moving ahead to find out what is actual problem to eradicate the discrimination between the humans. We all know that we all are human beings. We all have a similar capacities. We may have a different mindsets, but we all have the common capabilities. But still, why do we never recognize others as equal to us? That's because of the attitudes change very slowly. Though everybody knows the Constitution of India clearly states no discrimination, no caste barriers, no any kind of denial of access to public places or no practice of untouchability principle. Still knowing all these things, people are reluctant. People are very rigid. People never accept the fact that we all are equal. It is because of the basic fact that attitudes change very slowly. Though the people know that discrimination is a severe offense, it is a punishable offense according to the Constitution of our country, still they never ever try to recognize others as equal to us. They have to change that attitude. Then only it becomes easy for the society to grow, and the attitudes need to be changed slowly or fast. Attitude has to be changed. Then only the success follows us. Now, the issues of equality in other democracies. As we generally feel that in India only we have various castes, various religious people, so there is a lot of discrimination only in our country like India. No, There are many democratic countries in the world who are still struggling to get equality for their citizens. So one such example is the United States of America. The United States of America, as we feel, is the most well-advanced countries in the world. But still, there also we have these inequality issues. The Afro-Americans who were taken as slaves were in the 19th century, who settled there and the next generations have come up. But still, there is a lot of discrimination between the whites and the blacks in United States. One such incident happened on 1st of December 1955 when Rosa Parks, who was a black lady, who refused to offer a seat to a white man after the tired day work in the evening when she was traveling in the bus. There was a rule and a provision that the whites, when they come or step into the bus, the blacks have to stand and give place for the whites. And they are not supposed to use the same restaurants which are used by the whites. They have separate restaurants for them, separate schools for them, which are not entitled for them. Mostly they study in the government schools, where the quality of the teachers was really very less. Now moving on. So when Rosa Parks rejected to offer the seat to the white man, which triggered for a huge agitation the next coming days, and it resulted in the civil rights movement. Finally, in 1964, under the able leadership of Abraham Lincoln, the Civil Rights Acts were able to be passed. So now, as the time passed on, people know that it is very difficult to recognize the others are as equal as us. Even the constitutions declare, even the laws are there, even though it's a punishable offense. That's the reason why it has become a challenge for many of the democratic countries to attain this equality in their societies. So no country is perfect. No country is left out without any issue of inequality. There are on the name of the caste, they are on the name of the color, they are on the name of the religion, whatever may be the banner, but everything is inequality related issue only. And so we need to strive hard for the expansion of the idea of democracy, in which the basic fundamental is to recognize every individual is equal and has a dignity and honor for every individual. So this scope has to be expanded and the idea of democracy has to be expanded further. There are many issues and many new issues to come in the process of expansion of democracy and the concept of equality. But still, we need to struggle and maintain the society on the guidelines of equality, providing equal opportunity, equal respect, and respecting the dignity of every individual with honor and pride, so that everybody feels safe and secure and respected equally in the democratic societies. So that's all we have in this lesson on equality.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.